Welcome to the channel. In this video, we will see how we can build a simple banking system using the Python programming language. Here, we will have the options to check the balance, deposit and withdraw funds. Now, once we are done with this program, when we run this, it will display the options to deposit, withdraw, check balance and exit the program. Here, if I want to check the balance, I have to enter a number. You know, it will display the balance that I have in my account. If I want to withdraw, then we have to choose an option. And here we have to enter the amount that we want to withdraw. Let us say $200. And if the balance is there in our account, then only we will be able to withdraw. Otherwise, it will say insufficient funds. And finally, in order to deposit, we can choose an option. We can enter the amount that we want to deposit, and that will be added to our account. Now, once we have balance in our account, if we go for checking the balance, it will display that account balance. And similarly, if you want to withdraw, you know, we will be able to withdraw the amount as long as it is less than the amount that we have in our account. In order to terminate this program, we will enter an option. It will terminate the program. Now let us see how we can build this. Now in this video, we will mainly focus on building the menu system. In the next video, we will build the banking system behavior. That is, we will build the options to deposit funds, withdraw funds, and check balance. So here, we will mainly focus on building the menu. Now here, what we will do is, we will define a function, and I will call it as main. And this main function will be the entry point of our program, and it will display the menu. Depending on the user's choice, it will perform specific operations. Now here, we will keep on displaying the menu as long as user wants to run this program. For that, we will use the while loop in here, and I will make the condition for this while loop as always true. So it will be an infinite loop, and then we will have the menu. So here, this will be the menu that we will display. We will say banking system, and then we will display the options for the user. One is for deposit, two for withdraw, three for check balance, and four for exit. Now, after seeing this menu, the user has to enter his choice. So what we do is, we will use the input function, and we will ask the user to choose an option. Now the user can enter a number from his keyboard. Now what we do is, we will store the choice that the user has entered in a variable, and I will call it as choice. Now one thing that we have to remember here is, this input function returns the user input in the form of a string value. This choice variable is containing a value of type string. Now what we have to do is, we have to check for the value that the user has entered, or in other words, we have to check for the user's choice, and we have to perform that particular operation. So what I will do is, I will use the if else conditional statement. So I will use if here, and I will check whether the user has entered the option one. For that, we will write if choice equal to string value 1. Remember, I said the choice variable contains the value in string form because this input function returns the user input in string form, and we are not converting that to number. If you want, you can do that, but here I'm not doing that. So now here, what is this option 1? Option 1 is for depositing the amount. Now when the user wants to deposit amount to his bank account, what we have to do is, we have to ask how much amount you want to deposit. So here I will use the input function, and I will display this message: enter the amount that you want to deposit. The user will enter a value, and this input function will return that value in string form. So here we want to work with the numbers, and that's why we will convert the user input to number form by using this float function, and then we will store that user input in number form in a variable, and I will call it as amount. Now after that, what we have to do is, we have to perform the operation of depositing the funds. Now here, I will not implement this deposit funds right now. We will do that later. For the time being, we are building the menu. Once we are done with that, we will implement this functionality. Now, after this, we will go for the option 2. Option 2 is for withdrawing the funds. So here, we will have the ELIF conditional statement. So it will be ELIF, and then we will check whether the choice that the user has entered is 2. So here, if you see, 2 is for withdrawing the funds. So what we want to do here is we want to implement the functionality of withdrawing the funds. Again, when the user wants to withdraw the amount from his account, what we have to do is we have to ask how much you want to withdraw. So here again, similar to the way we have done while depositing the funds, we will ask the user to enter the amount that he wants to withdraw by using this input function. Then whatever the value that the user enters, it will be returned by this input function in string form. We will convert that to float type. We will store that in a variable and we call it as amount. Now here again, we will implement the withdraw functionality later. Now after that, we will go for the choice 3, and that is for checking the balance. So here again, we will have the ELIF conditional statement and we will check whether the user has entered the choice 3. If it is so, what he wants to do is he wants to view the funds that he has in his bank account. So here we will implement this functionality later. So here we will say view funds, and we will display a message, you know, just for the time being, stating that viewing funds. And similarly, you know, if you want, you can add the message to this part. So here, you know, depositing funds, and then here withdrawing funds. Now remember, we have not implemented these functionalities. We are just building the menu. Okay. Now the next choice that we can see here is for exiting the program, and for that user has to enter 4. So we will check for that. So here again, we will have the ELIF, and we will check whether the user has entered the choice of 4. Now, if the user wants to exit this program, what we have to do is we have to stop this while loop. So as long as user enters a input other than this 4, we will keep on running this while loop. So when the user is going to enter 4, we will stop this while loop. And for that, we will have the break statement in here, in this choice 4. Now, you know, before the break statement, we can display a message like this: exiting the banking system, goodbye, you know, something like that. And then finally here we will have the else block, and this else block will be executed only if the user enters a choice other than the values that we have mentioned here. So if the user is going to enter a number, let us say 8, or he can enter, you know, any key in his keyboard, in that case it will be processed in this else block. So here what we want to do is we will simply display a message stating that invalid option, please try again. Okay. So now here in this main function, we have built this menu. It will display these options. Depending on the user's choice, it will perform these specific operations. Now finally here, we will call this a main function. So what we do is we will make sure that this main function is called whenever this file is run as the standalone program, and that's why we check whether this name is containing main. If it is so, we will execute the main function. Now why we are using this is, for some reason, if someone imports this script to their project, then we don't want to run this main function. If this file is run as the standalone program, then only the main function will run, and it will display, you know, these options, and it will perform these operations. So now what we have done is we have built this main function. Let's run this and make sure that this menu part of the banking system is working properly. So I will run this program. It will display the message banking system, these options. Choose an option. I will say 3 for checking the balance. It says viewing funds. Again, if you remember, we're just using this viewing funds using the printf statement, and we have not implemented that part yet. We will do that later. And here we are just testing out the menu functionality. If I enter 1 for deposit, you know, it will ask the amount to deposit. I will say $100. You know, again, it will display depositing funds, and then the menu is displayed again. Now this time, if I enter, let us say 2 for withdrawing the funds, it will ask enter the amount. I will say $50, and you know, it will just display withdrawing funds, and then the menu is displayed again. Now if I enter any other random values, for example, if I enter the alphabetical character A here as the option, then it says invalid option, please try again. Now finally, in order to exit, I will enter 4. If I hit the enter key, the program terminates after displaying this message. So here we can say that the menu part that we have built here is working properly. All we have to do right now is implement this banking functionality. Now in the next video, we will implement the banking functionality for deposit, withdraw and check balance, and we will finish up the program. So this is it guys for this one. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later in the next video.